So that was a short description of user experience design. Now, a part of what I also love is user experience research. I mentioned earlier in your workflow, one of the things you do is you understand what the project is. And the second thing you do is you go to the user and figure out what does the user need, right? In some companies, they might go to a user experience researcher and say, you find out what they need. Is that, I don't have time for this. So there's an actual role out there, and some big companies like Microsoft Research has a lot of UX researchers. And it's also kind of related to H3I research. So I said in college, I worked in a human-computer interaction lab. And that is a bigger umbrella, so not just interacting with websites, but any kind of technology. You could actually interact. There's a field now called human-robotic interaction. Robots can't take over the world. How are we going to interact with it? We need designers to think about that, right? So what is this research? What's the purpose, right? We want to know what is the user thinking. Here's some chuckles. This is how we become like Professor Xavier, right? I want to read their minds, but I can't, unfortunately. I don't know if anyone else here can, but I can't. So what we do is we use research methods like a usability study. Usability study is when someone comes to your desk and actually uses your work. It's actually a really, really scary idea because I just came up with this amazing idea, told everyone about it, and then the person comes in and doesn't know how to use it. Fail, but that's why I do the test, so I can find out more and more how to better understand the user. I might do market research. So login pages aren't really a new thing. Right? Let's figure out what the market is already doing with login pages and learn from it. I might do ethnographic field research. That's, you know, if I really want to understand how to design a door, I'm going to go follow some grocery shoppers who are walking through malls and walking through stores and see how they use a door. If they are always confused by that door or always want to use a push-in for that kind of door over there, then okay, that makes sense for a push door. And A/B testing is another method. A/B testing is, I've got option A or B. There's two designs that I've made, and I'm not sure which one's gonna be better. I have an inclination, but like I said, sometimes those executives don't really believe that we know what we're doing. So, all right, I've got my idea, and there's executive idea. Let's put it out there, and I'm gonna have 20 people use these things. So 10 people will use A, and 10 people will use B, and then I'll compare their feedback. They'll say, oh, A was, they won't know there's a B. They'll just say, this was great, I loved it. Or they'll look at the executive idea and say, this was horrible, I don't want to use this company. And so that's research. That's the analysis that I can use to say, hey, this is a design that we can